Hi, my name is Ashwini Kumar and welcome to my channel. So before going into the main content of the video, here one announcement to the entire UGCNET exam aspirants. And if you are not belonging to this category, then you may skip this announcement. So the candidates who are preparing for the UGCNET exam, then the free live classes are providing in the UnAcademy platform. So the candidates who belongs to these subjects, the commerce, computer science, education, history, English, Hindi, geography, economics, labor, welfare, psychology, home science, environmental science, electronic science, philosophy, public administration, law, management, political science, and sociology. And including this one, the general paper, that is teaching and research aptitude. So the candidates who belongs to these subjects, you are going to get the free live classes in the UnAcademy platform. So to avail this one, you have to install the UnAcademy learning app that I am providing the link in the description box of this video. And also along with that link, I am providing my WhatsApp number in the description box of this video and the subscription also. So here the free classes and the paid classes, both these two are provided by the UnAcademy. So the free classes you can able to access freely provided by the educator regarding to particular subject. And if you want to take the plus course, the plus course means the complete syllabus of your subject is going to be covered clearly with live classes, and your doubts will be cleared in the doubt clarifying session. And here these are the different subscription plans are provided for the plus classes: 1 month, 3 months, 6 months, 12 months, and the 24 months. So out of these plans, you may take any one of the plan based upon your requirement. And if you are using this code Ashwini K, then you are going to get the 10% discount on any one of these subscription plans. In this video, we are going to see the list of Indian institutes with research areas. That means why I am bringing this video, because most of the PhD aspirants are trying to do the PhD in the institutes and in the universities and in the private or deemed universities like that. But apart from these institutes, we are having the research institutes in India also. That means you can try for your PhD admission in such type of research institutes. If you do your research program or PhD program in such type of research institutes, then you are going to get the more practical knowledge while comparing to the PhD program in the normal colleges or universities. Before going into this list of research institutes, don't forget to subscribe and share the channel to get the updates regarding UGCNET Paper 1 self-preparation videos and UGCNET Paper 2 electronic science self-preparation videos, faculty JRF, SRF and PhD notifications in IIT, NIT, IIIT, central and state government as well as private universities, and the latest news regarding NTA, UGC, NET. To get the latest updates regarding all these topics as a notifications to your mobiles, laptops or desktops, don't forget to subscribe the channel, and after subscribing, press the bell icon. And if your friends or colleagues are also looking for the same topics, then please share this channel link to them also. It will be helpful to them. So it is a PDF that I downloaded from the DST, that is Department of Science and Technology. It is a PDF with a total 40 pages, which is completely listing the Indian institutes with research areas. I will provide this URL link in the description box of this video. You need not to search in the Google. You just go to the description box of this video and click on this one. Then you are going to get this official PDF regarding the list of Indian institutions with research areas announced by the Department of Science and Technology. And while coming to this one, a list of Indian institutes with research areas. This is only a suggestive list of Indian institutions which may be suitable for joint research opportunity to scientists interested to apply for fellowship under RTF-DCS program. The applicants are, however, free to approach any other institutions in India relevant to their areas of interest. So the candidates who are trying to get the PhD admissions in the universities or colleges, then you just have a look on this list of this research institutes also. But because if you do your PhD in such type of research institutes, you are going to get a very good practical knowledge regarding the research whatever you are doing or you are done. So the number of institutions listed in this document, areas of research.
The agricultural sciences, total 66 institutions are there, main research institutions. And while coming to the biological and medical sciences, total 60 institutes are there. And in chemical sciences, 9, physical sciences and mathematics, 16, health sciences, 16, engineering sciences, 23, materials, minerals and metallurgy, 9, and multidisciplinary and other areas, 17. So total, we are having the 216 research institutes in India. Okay, and while coming to the agricultural sciences, see here the complete details are given here, name of the institution and research areas and the contact person is also given here. Indian Agricultural Research Institute, IARI, New Delhi. So the official website is also given here, and this institute is going to be do the research areas on the topics, that is genetics and plant breeding, plant pathology, microbiology, post harvest technology. And here the contact person with telephone number and email ID is also given. So if you want to do your PhD in these areas, then you once go to this institute, or else you just mail your whatever the work you've done on these research areas. If you publish any journals, all these things, and mention your interest, all these things to this mail ID and to this person. Okay, so he is a principal scientist and in charge PME. And while coming to the next one is the Indian Institute of Horticultural Research. It is in Bangalore, Karnataka. So here the official website is also given here. So like that, in this PDF, the total, whatever the institutes we discussed, that means total 216 institutes are mentioned regarding the different research areas, with name of the institution and the official website and the research areas and the contact person, everything is given here. So it's a very good information to the PhD aspirants who are really passion in doing the research with practical knowledge. Here all the research institutes with official websites and the contact person mail ID, complete information is given here. So it's a complete 40 pages are there, and you just go through this one depending upon this topmost index. That means while coming to the areas of research, if you belongs to any one of this research area, then you just go through this page. Okay, regarding the, if you belongs to physical science and mathematics, then go to the physical science and mathematics page. And total 16 institutes are there in India that they are focusing on the research in these areas. Okay, physical science and mathematics. So like that, if you belongs to the engineering sciences, then go to that one. And here I will show one thing. While coming to the Indian Agricultural Research Institute, you just click on this one on the official website. It is the official website of the ICAR, that is Indian Agricultural Research Institute. And if you want to do the research work, or if you want to do the PhD in this research institute, then you just go to this academics and click on the admissions. And in this admissions, see here, system of admission, MSc or MTech degree courses. Entrance examination for admission to MS or MTech degree courses at IARI is undertaken by the Education Division of ICAR, and on the basis of the merit, the ICAR finalizes admission for MSc or MTech degree courses in 26 disciplines at IARE. And the second one is the PhD degree courses. Admission to the PhD degree courses in 26 disciplines shall be made on the basis of the performance of candidates in the written test examination, entrance examination, 80% weightage, plus academic score 10% weightage, plus interview 10% weightage. Entrance examination will consist of one paper of three parts. Part 1, general agriculture, and part 2 and 3, subject paper. And academic score shall be calculated on the basis of percentage of marks obtained in various examinations from the matrix, that is 10th standard onwards. Next, advertisement for PhD admission. So how the PhD admission advertisement will start and when it starts and how many number of seats are going to be and the reservation for the reserved category and eligibility, all these things are perfectly mentioned here. So you just go through this one. So likewise, if you are really interested and passionate to do the research work, then instead of focusing on the universities, it's very good to focus on these research institutes. Okay, you are going to get a very good practical knowledge, that I am sure for that one. And there is a chance to get the patent rights also, to put up the patent for your research work. Okay. In my next videos, I am going to give the in detail information regarding the each and every institute. That means here the total we are having the 216 research institutes are there in India. So I'm going to give the in detail information, that means regarding the PhD information and eligibility and when they are going to announce the, when they are going to give the PhD advertisement in particular research institute. All this information I'm going to do in the next 216 videos that clearly explains about the each and every research institute. Okay, so please don't forget to subscribe the channel to get all these notifications to you, and after subscribing, press the bell icon. And if this information is also useful to your friends, then please share this channel link to them also. It will be helpful to them. Thank you.